Good morning, students, and welcome to Travel and Tourism Day 7. Today's topic is going to be the difference between travel agencies and tour operators. So before we look at the differences, children, I want you to recall the flowchart that I had shown to you in one of the previous classes. The flowchart in which I have mentioned consolidators and what the consolidators do. The consolidators have the tourist products in bulk. Tourist products as in hotel accommodation, transportation, restaurants, tickets for different amusement parks, tickets for different sites while sightseeing, right? And they sell all of this to the tour operators. Now, who are the tour operators? They are the people who assemble all these elements and create a package, right? And then the tour operators sell this package to the travel agencies. The travel agencies market it. And just to recall, in the last class we had seen the pictures wherein I had shown you the advertisement page of DPOLS and SOTC. You remember that? Yes. That's how they market the tour packages to the customers. So now you remember the flowchart: consolidators, tour operators, travel agencies, and then come the consumers. All right. Now, let's try and understand the difference between travel agencies and the tour operators and how their roles are different and how as an organization also they are different from each other. Right. Now, let's see the first difference. The major difference between tour operators and travel agencies is in the system of providing services to the customers. A tour operator is a company that buys certain services from different companies. That means different consolidators, and forms a single tourist product out of them using its own pricing system. Whereas a travel agency acts like an independent reseller. Right now, the travel agency is not gathering the tourist products and assembling it. No, they are just buying the tour package. The assembling part is of a tour operator. The assembling part is not of a travel agency. They are an independent reseller. Reseller as in what they get, they have sold it here. They are not doing the part of assembling the packages. They are only marketing. All right. Its profit is the commission for the sale of the operator's tour to customers. What is the commission? The sale of the operator's tour to the customer. How do they get that commission? That's why the agent's price is usually higher. Although there are moments when agents deliberately understate their prices. This is a very important point, children. And I want to explain this very clearly. The tour operators are selling the package to the travel agent, right? At one rate. Say, supposing the tour operator is selling the package to the travel agency at 5 rupees, but the travel agency is selling it to the customers in 10 rupees. So that 5 rupees extra is the commission, right? So I want you to understand that the price at which the tour operator is selling to the travel agent is not the price in which the travel agent is selling to the customer. The travel agent will always quote a higher price. It's written here. That's why the travel agent's price is usually higher. All right, students, I hope you understood this important point clearly. Now let's look at difference 2. Usually, a tour operator is a comparatively large company in comparison with a travel agency. What they're trying to tell you here is that a travel operator's company is large. When we say large, that means more people are involved. That means more resources are involved. Now, children, let me take you back to the flowchart. A tour operator is getting all the tourist products from the consolidator. So, do you think one consolidator will be having all these elements? No. There'll be many consolidators. Right? In that way, the tour operator is in contact with lot of people. People who deal with hotels, people who deal with restaurants, people who deal with ticketing. That too in bulk. Right? So, a tour operator's company is large in comparison to a travel agency. Now, why it is large? Let's understand that. It has its main office and several subsidiaries in order to offer their services to more potential customers. Subsidiaries means, let me explain this term to you. Supposing my company's name is John and Co. Okay? And I am a tour operator. I want to give you a package. I will collect different elements from the consolidator. Right? Now, when I am giving the travel agent the package, the travel agent will sell it to a person. But the travel agent will depend on me, that is John and Co., to do all the groundwork, to make sure that all the elements in the packages are done correctly when the person goes for that particular trip. So, supposing if a person is going to Dubai, I have to make arrangements in Dubai. How will I make that? I will be making that through the subsidiaries that I have in Dubai, the people who are going to help me to execute this trip. So always remember, children, tour operators will have several subsidiaries to help them out. Okay? Let's see the next point. Many big tour operators have subsidiaries in different countries. Irrespective of the number of subsidiaries, a tour operator usually concludes agent agreements with. That means what? Finally, whose package goes to the travel agent, only the tour operator knows. But he will have many people at the back hand to help him. Okay? With independent travel agencies that then sell the operator's tour to the customer. So the Agent doesn't know anything. Agency, travel agency never knows anything. Only the tour operator will know because he is in contact with the different people who are ready to sell these tour elements, that is the tour products to him. Right? Let's move to the next point. The more partners a tour operator has in as many countries and regions as possible, the more the sale volume is. Children, it's very important for a tour operator to have many partners in many countries. Why? Because if he doesn't have these people to help them out, how he can sell the tour packages to the travel agency? Because at the end of the day, the tour operator only has to do the groundwork. So, for example, if the tour operator is giving a package for Sri Lanka, he has to have contacts in Sri Lanka to help him execute this trip. Once the travel agent sells the trip to the customer, execution part is of a tour operator. That's why his contacts in different countries is very important. Supposing if a tour operator does not have any contacts in, say, Morocco or Istanbul or Cappadocia or say, New Zealand, he will not be able to sell tour packages for that area because who's going to execute the trip? Right, children? So you have to understand a tour operator will have subsidiaries and will have partners or contacts in different countries. The more the contacts, the more the sales volume is. And correspondingly, the more tourists will buy its tour and the more profit it will gain. Students, I'm going very slow and I'm going difference by difference so that you understand what I'm trying to tell you. Right? So please listen carefully and make notes if you want to. Whatever I've mentioned in the slide is from the book, but all the examples that I'm giving you, you can please write it in a notebook and keep these examples ready because children, your answer will have weightage if you give good examples. Right? All right. Difference number three. A tour operator may be a supplier, meaning all right. Let's move to difference three. A tour operator may be a supplier, meaning they might own hotels or car rentals. So, this point has two meanings to it, children. See, a tour operator may be a supplier. See, already a tour operator is supplying the package to the travel agency. But this is something else. A tour operator may be a supplier, meaning they might own hotels or car rentals in a different country, or they may be having a tie-up, okay? And allow to use their own inventory. That means their own, say, the cars that they are having or the hotel that they are having or their supplying partner inventory for a fee. Supplying partner, that means tie-up, okay? And then the tie-up people would be charging them a discounted amount, right? A travel agency is only a distributor, and typically travel agents rarely own any travel assets. That means travel agency does not own any assets. They don't own any hotel, or they don't tie up with a hotel in a different country, or they don't have car rentals that they own in different country. But a tour operator sometimes may have these facilities in different countries, right? So a travel agent is only a distributor, he is not a supplier, and they don't own any assets, whereas tour operators sometimes own assets. Let me give you a simple example. Supposing a tour operator is in Delhi, okay, and his brother, okay, is working in Sri Lanka as a car rental or a transport owner, where he sends out buses and cars. So this tour operator can contact his brother and tie up with him and give him sales. So all the customers will be diverted to this particular brother who is in Sri Lanka, who will help them with the transportation, right? So this is how they do tie-ups, and this is how they sometimes own things also in a different country, right? Let's move to difference 4. Travel agencies are less inclined than tour operators to perform ground service. This is a very important point, children. See, travel agencies do not help or do not take care of ground services. That means they do not take care of what is happening in the other country. Only the tour operator takes care of it. Now, how can I explain this in a better way is, let me tell you an example that happened with me, so you will understand this better. When I was traveling to Andamans, one day stay booking was in one hotel, all right? The next day's stay booking was not reflecting in the hotel. So I got panicked, okay? So I called the travel agency who did my bookings. They were Flight Shop, okay? I called them and I said, you have not booked me for the next day in this particular hotel. Why? So what did the Flight Shop people tell me? Ma'am, give me 10 minutes. I will get back to you. So now you understand this, children. So the Flight Shop people will get in touch with their tour operator and ask them ki why this did not happen. So direct bookings were not done by Flight Shop. They look up to the tour operator. So the tour operator then contacted the hotel and booked me for the next day also. So the travel agency is just a mediator. They are just marketing and they may help you, but they will not conduct the ground operation, right? A travel agency may deal with one component of travel. That can be either your flight tickets, or it can be, sometimes they also do hotel, but mostly they ask their travel operator only to do hotels. So a travel agency may deal with one component of travel product, while a tour operator offers a variety of tour programs. So your tour operator will take care of your pickup and drop, your airport transfer, your sightseeing, your stay, all right, and your local guides. So travel operator does a lot more work than the travel agency students. Okay, I hope this class was informative. I have given you 4 good differences with examples. I hope that you have made notes. Now, looking at the task that you need to do, let's see this. List out the difference between travel agency and tour operators. Represent it in a tabulated format. Now, what do I mean by tabulated format? I want you to divide a page into two. One side you will write travel agency, on the other side you will write tour operator. You will first define both the terms, and then you will give me 5 differences between both with example. I want a detailed assignment on this, children. Please work on it. Your deadline is the 8th of April. You know my email ID. You can send in your assignments with your name. Also, if you have some doubts, you want me to do a particular topic again with more elaborate examples, please let me know. I will do it for you. Right? Hope to see your assignments soon, children, and I will see you in the next class. Have a good day.